Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the class of how to create a LinkedIn ads. In our previous class, we have discussed about the different advertisements which can be published in LinkedIn. That is, how can we, what are the different advertisements which can be used in LinkedIn? And today we are going to discuss how to create an advertising campaign in LinkedIn. So we all have seen in our previous class that yes, LinkedIn plays one of the major role. LinkedIn is again one of the top social media, which is again generating leads to B2B business. So LinkedIn is again a social networking application or a website. And nowadays where we are using it to promote the goods and services, sell the goods and services. And also one of the important part of LinkedIn is again to generate the leads to the company. So whenever we speak about sales, whenever we speak about promotion, again leads plays a very vital role in the business. So we should rightly identify who are our target customers. We should rightly promote the goods and services to the target audience, and we should come up with the right promotional strategies. We should come up with the right promotional mix and also the pricing strategies so that we can easily identify and target our audience. So through this LinkedIn ads, yes, like YouTube, we are also going to concentrate on our target customers and also come up with the different types of advertisements which will help us to identify which advertisement is suitable to our business and which advertisement is costing how much and what are the different features of different advertisements. So we are going to study one of the important topic, that is how to create LinkedIn ads. So now yesterday we all have seen that again, the types of LinkedIn ads. And now today we are going to see about what is the different or what are the different ads which we can come up with. And every single week content in LinkedIn feed is seen by 9 billion times. So now you can understand the visibility of the content when it comes to LinkedIn. And plus we have almost 250 million active LinkedIn users and only 3 million shares or 3 million customers share content on a weekly basis. And that's just over a percentage of monthly users. So when we have come across that only 250 million active LinkedIn users and only 3 million share a content on weekly basis. Generally, there are many people who maintain an account in LinkedIn only for the sake of others, only for the sake of visibility. But now when you speak from the point of a business, you need to make sure that you need to continuously update your content, continuously make sure that your keywords are matching your website content or matching your business strategy. So we all should understand the different steps used by the company that is to advertise in LinkedIn. The first one is, again, the first step, is my screen visible to everyone?
Yes.
The first step in creating a successful advertising on LinkedIn is you need to get started with the LinkedIn campaign manager. So now I'll show you what is campaign manager and also how it works. Initially, now we are going to cover the theory part. Then later on, after the class, I'll show you how to create all these things. And Mr. Sharif, on Friday or Thursday, I guess you left the class early, right?
Yes.
So I was showing you the different types of advertisements which can be used in LinkedIn.
Okay.
I guess Mr. Swadesh Narayanji was there. So I was discussing all those things. Whatever I have discussed in a theoretical part, I was conveying the same thing. That is, I was showing them how to identify the different ads and everything. Maybe after the class, even today, you please wait so that we will go through it practically.
All
is
right,
it clear?
Thank you.
Next one is, once you select or once you get started with the campaign manager, next one is you need to set up your campaign. And my dear students, you all should understand one basic thing. Always keep in mind, you need to identify why you are setting up this campaign. What is the purpose of this campaign? And what is the goal of this campaign? Whether to create awareness, whether to build brand awareness, or whether to promote your goods and services, or to increase the number of visitors, or to increase the visibility of your website, or to increase the visibility of your product or services, that is with the help of this LinkedIn campaign. So you should understand the goal and the objective of the campaign. For what purpose you are building this campaign? And next one is, you need to name your campaign. My dear students, you all should be very much clear about naming the campaign, because being a company comes up with many campaigns. They have different campaigns. A campaign only, for example, a separate campaign can be created only to create awareness. A separate campaign can be created only to build the brand. A separate campaign can be created only to influence the people to purchase the goods and services or to purchase the products, that is to increase the sales. And there are campaigns created only to create the loyalty among the customers. So now, once you have set up your campaign, you please name your campaign. Campaign of what? Creating awareness. Campaign of what? Creating brand building. So you need to create the name, or you need to write the name of your campaign, so that in near future, it may not be confusion to you. If you ask me, what is the confusion here? Today you are doing a campaign on creating awareness, or today you are doing a campaign on brand building, and tomorrow you may come up with next other activity. So during that time, if you don't campaign, if you don't name your campaign, you may end up in confusion and you may do the same thing what you have done earlier. Okay. So that is the reason why should we choose the campaign's name. And next one is, choose your audience. As I said you earlier and many times, as a company, we need to target, or we need to select our target audience. I said many times, not all customers are important to us. First, identify who are your target customers, who are your target audience, what are their needs and requirements, how to influence them, or how to convince them, or which ad or which website is again influencing them. So we need to identify our audience, that is about target audience. And then formally, you need to designate your ad format. So which format is suitable to you, whether you should go with content, whether you should go with PPC, whether you should go with CPM, whether you should go with SEO. So whether you should go with live streaming, whether you should go with in-stream, whether you should go with discovery, which ad format is suitable to you or to your campaign or to your products. So you need to select the right format, and finally configure your bidding options and campaign dates. So finally decide on what date you are going to release the campaign. That is, we are speaking about the advertising campaign. And then finally, add optional conversion trackings. So once when we understand who are our target audience, next I need to also check whether my target audience are being converted into customers. So you need to check the conversion rates. Conversion is nothing but converting into a customer, and then is add your payment details and review your order. So now this is for paid campaign. So generally you may not find some free, you may find some free campaigns, or you can do some free strategies, but they may not be effective as you hire a campaign manager. So these are the different steps what we follow in creating an advertising campaign, especially in LinkedIn. The first step is get started with the LinkedIn campaign manager. So if at all, if you want to go here, what you are supposed to do to start, you are supposed to log in into linkedin.com. Then That is slash ads and click on create ad. Okay, can you see here the picture explains you? And once there, select the account you want to choose, then choose create campaign. The second picture explains you about account. Can you see here there is an option called account? Is it visible to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Right. First one is get started. Go to linkedin.com/ads and then create on ad. And then we go to create an account. So here you can find there are already accounts created. Okay. So now you need to create this account and specifically mention your company's name. What is the state? What is the created date? And how much you have spent on it? And what is the total budget? And what this campaign is all about. So now you are supposed to do this. This is the first step in creating a advertisement in LinkedIn. The next one is set up your campaign. The second step is again, set up your campaign. So click create campaign. So once you have created the account, then we are going to click on the campaigns. So here, as an example, here you can see Alexandra's account. Can you see this?
Yes, sir.
So now there is an option called create campaign. So in this campaign, again, they ask for some basic details. What is the company's name? How much you are trying to spend on this campaign? What are the key results which you are expecting from this campaign? What are the impressions? How many clicks? And how many average CTR and so on? So once you click on this, then you will understand the different details. And being a company, you can easily fill them and go on to the next step. That is, here you all need to set an objectives. What are these objectives? Whether you are doing this campaign for awareness, whether you are doing it for conversions, or whether you are doing it for consideration. So now, can you see this objective here? The first one speaks about awareness. What awareness you are creating? That is again brand awareness. So what is consideration? So what you are expecting? What you are expecting in return out of this campaign? Consideration again has different meanings, my dear students. Here, the meaning of consideration is referred to something in return. When I'm spending so much, when I'm planning a campaign, I expect something in return, correct?
True.
So what is my consideration? Website visits, to increase the number of visits to my website. Or I want customers to get engaged with my website. Or I want to increase the video views. So this is what we call it as consideration. And next one is when it comes to conversions. Now I am supposed to convert a prospect into a customer. The first step in conversions, again, it is lead generation. The next one is website conversions. And the third one is job applicants. So what you are doing for, whether you are doing this campaign to generate the leads, so that after generating the leads, I can concentrate on my audience, that is target audience or target customers, and then provide them the necessary information and convert them into the customers. Or you are expecting some website conversions, or you are looking for a job applicants. So what are your objectives when it comes to conversions? So this is what happens once you set up a campaign, and this is how you are supposed to choose the campaign objectivity. Is it clear?
Yes.
The next one is name your campaign. So now you need to give your LinkedIn ad campaign a name, right? Why? Because in near future, if at all, if you're planning to come up with campaigns, it should not be a confusion to you. You should not do it repeatedly, or you should understand what we have done and what we are supposed to do in near future. So here, the default campaign group, that is the campaign, my objective of my campaign is to create awareness, that is brand awareness, and the date it is October 7, 2019. So this is just a date which is mentioned it. So you can write when you are starting, maybe January 3rd, January 4th, 2022, or maybe to create awareness, or maybe to conversion. So you can write the objective of this campaign, and this is only for your reference. So this will not be displayed. This is for your reference. So provide plenty of information. That way, if you have lots of LinkedIn ads in future, so if you are coming up with different campaigns or different ads, then again you need to name them, so that it should not be a big confusion for you, and you'll be able to easily tell the difference between them. Okay, and I recommend you including the name of your offer or promotion, and sometimes even write a quick summary about the audience whom you are targeting and what are the services you are going to provide through this campaign, so that you'll have a clear picture about the campaign, what you are doing. You all are there? The next one is choose your
audience.
So like Facebook advertising, even LinkedIn provides marketers with the wealth of options to target very specific users. Do you remember when we were discussing about YouTube advertisements, you all might have seen the segmentation process. It was asking for a gender. It was asking for an age group. It was asking for the location. It was asking about the demographical factors, the geographical information. So when we provide, or when we try to collect the information from our audience, then we can easily identify them and come up with the required services to your target audience. The more specific your target market is, the more you can tailor your messaging to them. See, that's why I tell you many times, just some time back I said to you, even now I'm telling, not all customers are important to me. Identify who are your targets, for whom your services or products are manufactured, or services are rendered to whom. So what is their requirement? What is the expectation out of this campaign? What customers are expecting from you? And this results in a higher conversion rate, because your ads will be extremely relevant to the users who see them. So now, according to their requirement, we are going to come up with the campaign. The first one is, you can target your LinkedIn ads by location. So to which location customers it is, which region. Generally, when we speak about the segmentation is again based upon factors like geographical factors, demographical factors, psychographical factors, and behavioral factors. When I speak about geographic, under geographic again region comes. According to the region, I come up with a campaign. I target the audience according to the region, that is according to the north region, east region, west and south, and according to sometimes even climate, that is hot, moderate and cold. So there are services, even there are products even produced according to the climate. And there is again according to urban, semi-urban and rural, we can company comes up with different products and services. So you need to provide the information, that is again segment them according to the factors. The second thing comes with company name, industry and size. So whom do you want to serve? For which company these services are? So to which industry that company belongs, and what is the size of the company, that is whether it is a large scale, small scale or medium scale. And next one is according to job title, function and also seniority. You all should not forget, even LinkedIn helps us in providing, or LinkedIn provides the services of jobs. They help us to get a job, correct? Are you all aware? LinkedIn, yes. Jobs. So what kind of job title you are expecting or you're looking for? What is the function? What is the seniority level? And next one is you are going to fill the, also ask them to fill the details like school, that is address where they have studied, field of study, and also the degrees. And apart from this, we are going to also concentrate on some of the demographics called age. Age is again a demographical factor. Gender is again the demographical factor. Years of experience, company connections and followers, and member groups. So once you collect the information, the required information from the target audience, then you can easily go with the next one. So can you all see this picture on the screen?
Yes.
Select a specific targeting criteria to zero in on your ideal audience. So now I have come up with many options. Correct? Can you all see these options?
Yes.
The first one is again the company name, the company industry, the company size, job title for which you're looking, job function, job seniority. They're speaking about your member school, so that is again about your where you have completed your education, fields of study, degree, and the skills which you possess. Right? So the gender, age, years of experience, company followers, company connections. So these all are nothing but the different criteria to select or to choose your audience. And it is important to know that you don't have to use all of these options. Okay? Do you think that the people or the customers will respond according to all the options? No, they may select only few, which is again related to them. Okay? But still, LinkedIn provides the detailed information wherein the targeting leads to more relevant ads and a high return on investment. So that's why we should why should we understand, why should we collect all this information is again to understand what they are expecting from us and being a company, what is the return on investment. And you need to choose from your own saved audiences and preset LinkedIn audience filters or custom parameters. So this is again choosing your audience. You all understood this?
Yes.
The next one is again choose from your saved audiences. That is preset LinkedIn audience filters or custom. So you have already chosen or you have already saved, and again from them you are going to filter a few of them. Okay. Now you can see when it comes to audience here, it is saved audiences. Can you see this? And out of this, again, we are sub-targeting them. That is, where is your target audience? So, location, recent or permanent location, and we can include the locations from which area you are targeting your customers. And there is another option called when you select a specific location, that means you are excluding other locations. That is people in other locations, and you need to select the language. Generally, according to the country, the language will be selected, but globally, English is selected so that everyone can understand. But there are few countries wherein their language is totally different, so they may select their language. Have you seen LinkedIn in any other languages? Any of them?
No, for me, no.
Obviously, we find it in a global language called English, but still there are different options. Okay, we will check while we are doing it practically. Okay,
Okay, sir.
and next one is after doing that, let's scroll down for LinkedIn's advanced audience targeting. So, what is this? Which it gives you more control. So, when you speak about advanced audience targeting, it is nothing but you are searching according to the attributes. You are searching according to the needs and wants. You are searching according to the professions. So, that is what we call it as advanced. So now here you can see, we'll start building your audience by searching for attributes of professionals you want to reach. That is again, learn more about targeting criteria. When I speak about more, so there are again different criteria, like you are going to select only company wise, you are going to select according to the education, you are going to select according to the demographics, you are going to select according to the interest, or you are going to select according to the job experiences. So now what you are going to do is, you are trying to match a profile which suits you exactly. Whenever we speak about recruitment and selection, my dear students, what we do is, initially we try to recruit the people, correct? And then finally we try to select out of them. That is nothing but you are choosing the best out of these many. So you not waste time in this process. So directly go for advanced audience targeting, wherein you already know that what you are expecting and from where you are expecting these people, and what should be their education, what should be their experience, what should be the location. When everything is expected, or when everything is known to you, so why don't you directly select only those things? Then it becomes more easy for you. That is, again, you need to scrutiny few of the profiles. Again, you need to try to exclude few audiences. So doing all those things, it may take you a lot of time. It may use a lot of energy. So, and LinkedIn provides you advanced option, that is advanced audience targeting. Okay. So enable audience expansion. So these are the options which we have in audience, that is advanced audience targeting. So when we speak about advanced audience targeting, so here you can see add targeting criteria like the job title, industry or skills, whatever you are expecting from, and matched audience. Use your data to target or to retarget website visitors or reach known contacts and accounts. So now you found there are some matched audiences. Matched audiences from where? From website visitors, from contacts, that is again from your known contacts, that is from your known accounts. So generally you all should not forget that LinkedIn is again a networking site, correct?
Yes.
So even from our list of the networking, or even from our account, or even from our contacts, we can try to find out many people. So today, whenever you speak about recruitment, there are again different types of recruitments. Sources of recruitment, what I can call it as. Again, you have internal and external sources of recruitment. Right? Have you all come across internal sources of recruitment, external sources?
Yes.
So again, here I am referring to my internal sources, wherein I can find out through the known contacts and accounts. And next, what you are going to do is you can also save these audiences for future campaigns. And once you have selected your audience, LinkedIn Campaign Manager will summarize the details in the sidebar. So what are the things what you are expecting? As we have seen previously, it shows so many options. But now I have selected few. That is, select or choose target audience according to your requirement. That is, according to, you can see here, according to job seniority, according to the school, according to the degree, and according to the connections. So when you choose a specific option, then it shows only these fields. So now it is being shown in the picture. So your estimated target audience, you can see it on the right side, right? So the location is again United States of America. So what services you are expecting? Digital marketing, that is pay-per-click. What should be the experience? 1 to 3 years, and whom you are expecting to apply this job for, that is myself only, or you can even have that another options where others can apply. And once you select and once you get to know all the information, then we go to the next, that is again choosing your audience. Still we are in the fourth stem, but here what will be seen here, you will be able to see how large your estimated target audience is and make a necessary changes. So if the number of customers whom you are targeting, whom you are choosing, if it is a huge group, then again you need to come up with the different requirements. Okay, so below are the ad format choices. You can also use LinkedIn audience network settings to choose your ad placement, and this will surface your ads on their websites, on their applications, on their platforms outside of the LinkedIn for consistent and cross-channel messaging. So once, I don't know how many of them knows this, have you all come across Facebook?
Yes.
If you put a story in Facebook, there is an option that you can add the same story in Instagram. Have you all seen it?
No.
No? The same story what you put in Facebook can be added to Instagram, that is to other applications, but the content is same. Okay. If you have not seen, shown it, I will show it to you practically. Okay. So now you can see placement, LinkedIn audience network. Reach up to 25% more of your target audience by running your ads on LinkedIn and our partner applications, apps, and websites. So enable the LinkedIn audience network. So whenever you click on this option, the story or the advertisement will be again displayed on their applications, on their platforms, so that is outside of the LinkedIn.